Christian event. Even if you check back in the Bible, it was actually a feast of the heathens. Don't worry. The fact that Christians have set it aside to appreciate their Messiah, the enemy is not happy. He has timing. This is the time that we ought to be sensitive. This is the time where we ought to arise quickly. This is the time where we have to arise in prayer quicker than ever. This is the time where we have to arise in prayer immediately. If you have missed all the praying part, if you have missed all the fasting and prayer for the year, this is your moment to arise quickly. Amen. Am I talking to somebody today?
Amen.
Now I want you to know that I want us to, this particular time, I want us to talk about Herod. And you have to understand that the Herod that sent a decree in the book of Acts to arrest Peter is not the same Herod that wanted to kill Jesus in Matthew chapter 2. Am I talking?
Yes.
It is not even the same Herod that killed John the Baptist.
Yes.
I say now, you have to understand that here there is a generation of enemies. You don't understand. No. Maybe Herod is too far from you. And maybe Herod is too many years away from you. But I want to tell you that even in your family, the enemies that are fighting you are not starting with you. Some of the battles we are fighting are generational battles. Their grandfather has already fought our grandfather before they can fight our father, before they can start the battle with us. If you really understand what I'm saying, can I hear an amen?
Amen.
If you know what it is to fight battles, can I hear a better amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah. It was a generation of enemies. Herod the Great was the one that was after the life of Jesus. And because of that, he slaughtered all the babies during that time. He slaughtered his infants because he wanted, because of one person. I don't know that sometimes your enemies are so brutal. The enemies we fight are so brutal that we don't have the time to relax. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I just want us to do a prayer point here. I want us to do a prayer point where we are praying against generational, the heralds, the enemies of the gospel, those generational enemies that we are fighting. No, you don't understand. This particular one, I need to give it to Mama Kibobola. Please take a minute and crush those generational enemies. Help us with this one. If you understand, can we raise on our feet and deal with generational enemies in our lives? Amen.
Amen.
Bless the name of Jesus.
Hallelujah.
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 Calm down, Holy Spirit, calm down. We are waiting for you. Calm down. We are waiting for you. Calm down. Calm down, Holy Spirit, calm down. We are waiting for you. Calm down.
We command you to die in the name of Jesus.
in our generation must die. Do you understand? Even in the book of Acts, it took God to strike Herod in verse 23. God strike him, the angel of the Lord strike him, and he was eaten by worms. I believe every Herod in your life will be struck by the angel of God and will be eaten by worms in the name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. I am looking at Peter. Bible says that he was chained. He was not only chained. He was the guards that had him chained. Chained him and then chained him to them. So that in paraventure, if the chain fall off, he's chained to me, I can feel it. Hi. You don't understand the kind of chains that the enemy has put around you. The enemy is coney. The enemy is dangerous. The enemy is not happy with you. He doesn't only, it's not enough for him to put chains around you. He's still chained to himself. Now the story of Peter is very painful. Because here is Peter arrested in prison. Here is Peter knowing that these Herods don't play. Here is Peter that it is because of these Herods that his master escaped. And you have to understand that in the book of Acts chapter 2, Peter is the one who gave the greatest sermon. So he's somebody who understands the scriptures. He's somebody who understands timing. He's somebody who knows what scriptures say. Who knows what happened when Jesus was born. And here he is in prison, in chains. Peter saw his end. He saw his end. Are you seeing your end? Have the doctors gave you a report where you see your end, where it is humanly impossible to escape? This was the situation of Peter. Not only is he in prison, bound to soldiers, he received a news that one of his good friends, that a fellow colleague, has just been murdered. He received a message that James is dead by the sword from the same Herod. Hallelujah. Amen. While you are busy, as if your own chains is not enough, you receive a message, oh, your brother is died, your sister died, your brother, and you are like, oh my goodness, am I next? Peter is in a position where he's thinking he is next. And while his net security in prison is so tight that there is not even a way of escape. I don't understand if you understand the story of Peter. But I want to tell you that we are in that situation where we don't know if there's a way of escape. And there's only 21 days left. Bless the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. But the Bible says that the Lord commanded his angel. The Lord sent the word to Peter through his angel. The Lord sent a word through his angel. And during that particular time, Herod is excited. Herod is excited. You don't understand. We have another prayer point to make. He said, Herod is excited. Herod is saying, when he killed James, the Bible says after he has killed James, he realized that it pleases the Jews. And he was excited to kill another one because now he has supporters. Now the Jews are on his side. Some of the enemies that are after you, the visible enemy, there is another invisible enemy, household enemies, enemies from within that are rejoicing over your misery, that are rejoicing when your house is divorcing. They are excited as if they are crying with you. They are excited. They are gossiping behind you. Did you hear?
God bless
you. Year after year, she don't have a child yet. Did you hear? The invisible enemies, those enemies from inside, those enemies that you think they are standing with you. At least Herod is visible. There are other invisible enemies. They are Jews. They are supposed to be the people, the bloodline people. They are supposed to be the people to defend them. Because they are Jews like them. Those families that you think they are supposed to stand with you, they are the one fighting you. Apostle, please help me. Help me with this one. Let us fight the enemies from inside. Please give us another prayer point. From the enemies from within. Amen. Amen. And become aggressive. Amen. But as I said, today is your day.
Amen.
As I'm going off, I would like the choir to help me with a song that says there is power in the name of Jesus to break every chain. I want you, as the choir is ministering those that song, I want you to see the angel of the Lord telling you, arise. I want you to see the chains falling off from you as you arise. Hallelujah. As you arise, like Peter, be obedient. When Peter was told to arise, he arose. When the Lord is speaking to you to arise, if you want to see a breakthrough in your life, answer the call of God and arise. Answer the call of God and arise. Now, if you are there and you don't know Jesus, if you are there and you don't even know how to arise to this Jesus, if you are there and you have never even given your life to Jesus, I want you to move forward as the choir is singing so that we can pray with you. Bless the name of Jesus. So we can pray with you. Hallelujah. Bless the name of Jesus. Please help me. Let's do it very quick. I just have a minute and a half to do that. Hallelujah. Let's go.
There is power in the name of Jesus.